Y'all there? Everybody there? Hi, I'm Sue Serio from Fox 29's Good Day Philadelphia, and I am so happy you could all be with us on this special Facebook Live edition of the 44th anniversary of the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund. I have been honored over the last several years to work with this wonderful organization, and I'm so glad we could get together at all. I wish it was different, that it wasn't 2020, but I'm glad we have this technology that we can make sure that we let you know what's going on and how things are going and how things have been in the last 44 years. You know, Kellyanne Dolan's birth was something to celebrate because not only was she born on New Year's Eve in 1969, but she was Peggy and Joe's firstborn. She was an easygoing baby with the nickname of Moose because she was so rough and tough. But life would soon change for the family. When Kellyanne was just 2 years old, she was diagnosed with aplastic anemia, which evolved into an exceedingly rare form of leukemia. Kellyanne and her family spent days, weeks, sometimes months in the hospital. And on October 5th, 1976, Kellyanne died after a four-year fight with cancer. But through it all, Peggy always considered herself lucky. That's right. She says she was lucky because she wasn't a single mother. She had a husband and parents to lean on. She had insurance. She had money to buy gifts and keep their life going. Peggy was blessed to have the support and the means, but she noticed that too many moms and dads and families did not. There were too many who had to choose between their jobs and sitting at their sick child's hospital bedside. Too many who suffered drastic financial difficulties and could no longer pay their rent, their mortgage, their car payments, utility bills, or even birthday gifts. Well, helping these families became Peggy and Joe's mission and their destiny. And when the day after Kellyanne died, they created the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund. Ever since then, the mission has been simple: to lighten the burdens of families with seriously ill children. Whether it's offering financial assistance, providing adaptive equipment, or programs that insurance won't cover, or by simply giving families a day of fun. Well, today is the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund's 44th anniversary. And get this, in that time, they have touched the lives of over 34,000 families. They have provided $5 million in financial assistance, and they have lifted the spirits of 12,000 children and their families by providing gifts during that holiday season. While the pandemic has made it impossible for us to celebrate with the big bash we would love to have downtown, we are celebrating COVID-19 style with this Zoom party. And I am honored to welcome the co-founder of the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund, the incomparable, the extraordinary Peggy Dolan. Peggy, I know you're standing by, and we're so happy that you could be here with us this morning on this wonderful Facebook Live miracle.
Sue, not surprising, we're having some technical difficulties with Peggy, but you know what? We're going to admit Chris into the conversation right now.
Sounds fantastic. The voice you're hearing, by the way, is the incomparable Sarah Graham, who is our producer today, and she's getting everything together. So you know what? The Dolan Fund has a new executive director, and in case you haven't met him yet, here he is, Chris Dowdell. Hey, it is great to have you with us, Chris.
And great to have you with us, too. Thanks.
Once again, it's your producer, Sarah, and now I get to say welcome to Peggy. Chris, thank you for standing by. We appreciate
all
it.
Right. Hey, Peggy. I know you're here.
I'm here.
And I know you're not shy.
I know. Good morning.
Oh, Peggy, it's been an amazing 44 years, and I'm sure we could spend a lot of time having you tell us stories about those 44 years, but I'm just wondering, what's the most surprising thing that's happened in all that time?
Well, you know, they call me the storyteller, and I've had the privilege of working with a lot of kids from preschool all the way up to college age, and I'm always amazed, like when I have to address an assembly, how focused the kids are, how dead quiet a room can be with 1,000 middle school students, and the response that happens after my talk. I'll have kids come up to me and say, I really liked that talk. You know, I had one kid in particular that was coming down the aisle after an assembly, and he was real cute and shy, and he was sort of bouncing as he got to me, and he looked up, and he just said, he looked me straight in the eyes, and he said, "I really like that talk." And ever since Facebook came around, I now have so many of these students on my Facebook page, but I'm so proud of them because so many have gotten involved with charitable work. They're either doing, you know, working with the homeless, or they're working with disadvantaged. And one of the alumni from Tamanin actually started a nonprofit organization, and now he's working with ARC in Philadelphia. You know, some are working with children that are abused, and it's just, it's awesome. It's such a great feeling, and they're just loving kids, you know, and I feel privileged to have that.
Well, I think it's good that you inspired them while they were young, because obviously your story is something that stuck with them all these years. Mm-hmm. And you've worked with so many families, Peggy, in the 44 years as well. What continues to amaze you and impress you about the special families that you meet all the time?
Well, I'm always floored by the courage, first of all, the perseverance, the struggles that they go through, and they're still smiling, you know, and so very grateful for anything that we've done to be able to help them. And the sincerity is, it's just heartwarming, you know, and these different families we've been lucky to have on the cruises, the Spirit of Philadelphia, Spirit of New York, of Boston, and the Odyssey in Washington, to have the kids come up and the parents stand and talk to you and talk about their struggles. And it's just amazing. It's really, and what they go through, especially families with children that have severe disabilities, their lives are so focused and 100% on taking care of these kids physically and emotionally that, you know, it's an awesome experience to work with.
It is, and I'm loving looking at these pictures too, and I can only say that I hope it isn't too long before we'll be able to do events like that.
I know. Again.
Yeah, thank you so much. Now, Chris, I know you're standing by still, and of course, mentioning what's going on now with COVID-19 and all these increased challenges, I have to remember that we were supposed to have our TASTE event right before everything changed. It was what, March the 10th that was gonna happen, or maybe March the 12th, and then everything changed. And yet here we are, we're still helping people. I wanted to know from you, Chris, what kind of requests are you receiving now? How have things changed in this now world of COVID?
Sure. One of the big changes is that families facing the challenges, the normal family challenges, the parents may have lost employment, there's all kinds of social isolation, but now with the children at home so much more, whether your family has a severely ill child who is now only in the hospital when it's really life-threatening. As soon as it's not a life-threatening situation, that child's back home. Or disabled children that would normally go to school 5 days a week are now home those 5 days a week. And these parents need adaptive equipment and especially electronic communication equipment that they didn't need in the same quantity or service level before. And what I'm trying to say is a child, for example, who went to school 5 days a week may have seen a physical therapist on two of those days and an occupational therapist on another day. Well, now the parents need to be doing this all over the internet as they homeschool. They're trying to master certain techniques that their therapists used to practice with their children to see that their children don't regress. And we're providing everything to help with that from the broadband internet, a Chromebook for families that didn't have a good computer, to some of the adaptive equipment, a chair that sits the child in the right position for their therapy session. And of course, just like all of us, we're doing our doctor's visits over the internet. So those requests all related to being able to utilize what infrastructure is left those are the kinds of requests we're fulfilling now in a very large quantity.
Wow, there's so many things you don't even think of that have changed because of everything that's happened. How many families do you think you've helped during this time?
Well, I just looked that up. We, since March 12th, that's the date that we used as the starting point, 228 families.
Wow.
That have had a COVID-related issue. Now, that doesn't mean COVID in the family necessarily, but right. They've been impacted by the pandemic, and it's changed their course of their treatment or the course of their day-to-day routine significantly enough that they've come to us for help. And that's how many families since March 12th.
And how wonderful that you're still there for all of them. Now we have our one of those families joining us now.
Yes,
welcome, Lashay Solomon. And I believe her daughter Serenity is here as well. Are you there, Lashay?
Yes, hello, good morning, everybody.
Hi, so great to have you with us for this special celebration. Tell us your story. Tell us how the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund helped you in Serenity.
All right, well, my daughter's name is Serenity. She will be 3 years old this Thursday.
Is that her? Hi.
This is her brother. This is her brother.
Oh, her brother, okay.
She'll be three on Thursday, and she's just an amazing child. She's just very, very vibrant. She's a joy to be around.
We see her now. We see her picture.
She's just a really sweet child, and I'm just really grateful to you guys for that funding. I'm sorry if you hear them in the background. It's pretty loud.
It's okay.
She's full of joy. She's up early. She's laughing. She's playing. And we just really appreciate what you guys do.
What difference has the Kellyanne Dolan Fund made to you and your family? I'm sure it's a big one.
Yes, definitely a great difference. She, we have a lot of doctor's appointments due to her being born with congenital cataracts in both eyes. So that has a lot of appointments that comes with the surgeries, and she just got artificial lenses placed in both of her eyes this summer. So we've been back and forth to hospitals for overnight stays, checkups, multiple appointments, and also we're in the process of getting her evaluated for autism. So, you know, I'm out of work and I can't work to, you know, provide for them. So your fund had really helped with the things that she would use during her EI sessions and that we can use at home so that I can work with her outside of her sessions for early intervention.
So, so wonderful. And I think be pretty happy.
Yes, very happy. I know you can probably see her in the background.
Well, it makes us all smile and to know that y'all are hanging in there. And I know it's been tough, but we wish you all the best.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Now, thank you so much for sharing your story, Lashay. We want to talk now about the next event on the calendar of the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund, and that is the Holiday Adopt a Family program. It is still happening, but there are some changes. So Chris and Peggy are here to explain all of that to you. Take it away.
You want me to start, Peggy?
No, you're in the midst of it all. Chris.
We are so pleased that we will be able to have Holiday Adopt a Family going full speed ahead in light of the conditions during the pandemic and our normal situation. Of course, we bring hundreds of people together, thousands of toys, almost all of them brought to a single firehouse. And that's just a contact situation that's going to be a little here we go. Some scenes from last year. To make sure that we can get the family supported with gifts, with all the things they need for Christmas, but avoid too much close contact. We're going to be doing a gift card program this year that's going to be just as big as our regular program. Families can sponsor, families, corporations can all sponsor the families that we provide Christmas for. They will still learn about the family. They'll learn how many members are in the family and what sort of gifts are needed. But they'll be providing gift cards this year, which we will send to the families in a very safe way, whether it's a direct drop-off through the social worker, through the mail. And here are a lot of the gift cards that are really most important.
Oh, okay. These are the stores you want
gift cards. That's right. Right.
Okay.
Target and Walmart in particular for the gifts for the kids. An Amazon gift card will always work well. And the parents need to have some opportunity to get things like food for a holiday meal, some special equipment that might be available at a pharmacy. So the Walgreens and CVS cards can be really important too. I know that, you know, Peggy, you and I have talked a lot about how hard it will be not to see toys going into kids' hands this year.
You know, we have some of the most incredible and kind donors who really get into it. And because they understand from what they read about the family that they're serving, they get attached emotionally. And even after Christmas, they'll call to see if we know how their patient is doing, which, you know, obviously we can't tell them, and we generally don't know what happens beyond the point when we help. But so many people were involved, and the Wissahickon Fire Company donates their space their space to us for an entire week for us to collect the gifts and then to disperse them. But we've had school children come and help out, and the clowns and the firemen and Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus. We make it a party. It's such a great party. The kids are singing, and we just love it. And we're gonna miss that because it's given so much energy and joy to the whole holiday. But I know families and our donors are definitely going to understand that it has to be different, just like our lives are so different this year. But that these families really would appreciate gift cards, you know, and because we deal with all ages in the family. It's not just little kids who need toys. It's older kids that might need electronics or clothing. We get everything donated, but it's still gonna be a great holiday for the families because of our donors. And if anyone at all is interested, please join this particular program. It'll make a difference.
Yep. That's right. All you have to do is go to the website, right, guys? Dolanfund.org.
Yep.
That's correct. All the instructions you need. In fact, there's the information right there on your screen. We've got the address there, and we have the website, dolanfund.org, the 44th anniversary. It's pretty amazing. You know, this is really something we're celebrating, and we have a little bit of a surprise for you. We've sent something over for congratulations for the Peggy and Kelly and Dolan Memorial Fund. For the 44th anniversary, there should be a surprise arriving at some point.
Oh my.
And there are the flowers.
I got Kelly's daisies. She loved these things.
Oh,
you know, wherever we were and we see daisies growing by the side of the road, she would want to pick them, you know. Oh. And so daisies are definitely Kelly's flower. And of course, being a patient at Children's Hospital in Philadelphia, they always had Daisy Day. So we always celebrated that with them.
Such beautiful flowers.
Well, you see what's coming. You should
what else
here.
Could there be?
You should be here soon. Look at this. Here we can take.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, 44th anniversary cake.
It's a butterfly. Yeah. There's a butterfly on this cake.
A butterfly. That's our... That's us. That's us. That's our logo. Wow.
You should come over, Sue.
Bring you know what? Let's make it. Yeah, I'll bring some coffee and lunch.
Right.
Thank you, guys.
Some socially distant right. sweets.
Exactly. Exactly. Oh, smells so good.
Well, you guys share it and enjoy it. And you've
Thank
earned
you.
Every bit of the joy that you have brought to yeah. so many families, 44 years. We want to take this time to thank, of course, all of the supporters of yeah. the Kellyanne Dolan Memorial Fund, because you know that they can't do what they've done for 44 years and will continue to do without you. Thank you so much for this very, very special celebration. It's one
thank
we'll
you.
Always remember, right?
Thank you, Sue.
Thank you very yep. much, Sue.